Hello students, so far we have done practice of many questions of limits. Today I am going to start sums of exercise 13.1. So I have written few questions of your NCERT book of exercise 13.1. Let us start that. Question number 1. In question number 1, it is given that if limit extending to 3, it is x plus 3. So as I told you that if we put this limit x tending to 3 here, if we don't get 0.05, then the answer will be as it is, whatever we get by putting this limit. So if you put that x is equal to 3, then this is 3 plus 3, 6. This is not 0.04. So it means this is your answer. Okay. And question number 2, limit, well, if the limit is given pi, so x is tending to pi, and then in which function? The function is x minus 0.2 by 7. So we'll put the value of x, this is pi, pi is this 22 by 7. Let it be as it is because we don't know the value of pi, because value of the pi is not given, so let it be as it is. So now if we put the value of x, this limit 0 here, then what it would be? 0 plus 1 raised to power 5 means 1 raised to power 5, that is 1 minus 1 upon x is tending to 0. So this is 0.0 form. And as I told you, if you get 0.0 form, then either you will plan for rationalization, factorization, or any simplification. You can see this is not the question of any square root. Square root to have. So rationalization, no need of that. Factorization, can you do the factorization of this power 5? Nahi kar sakte, you don't know. Then because this is not a trigonometric function also, this is not another trigonometric function, so we can't apply this. This is not exponential function, this is not logarithmic function. So in this to koi apply nahi ho raha, to fir kaun sa bacha? This one is left from me. Haan, kuch kuch waisa dikhai de raha hai hume, x plus 1 raised to power 5, hai na? So it can be, and 1 to 1 ki power 5, dekho kya problem hai? 1 ki power, to you can write any power of 1 is equal to 1. लेकिन दिस क्वेश्चन इज नॉट ऑफ दिस टाइप, अभी भी ये नहीं आना है क्योंकि ऊपर जो है नीचे वही होना चाहिए. तो आई एम गोइंग टू राइट इट इन दैट वे सो दैट यू कैन फाइंड इट इन द सेम फॉर्म एज इट इज रिटन इन द क्वेश्चन. सो फॉर दैट आई मेक दिस इज प्लस 1, दिस इज माइनस 1. तो एक्स के साथ मैंने प्लस 1 किया, माइनस 1 किया, एड 1 सब्ट्रैक्ट 1, तो ये क्या हो गया? अब तो दिख रहा है ना वही फॉर्म हो गया कि नहीं हो गया? ओके, अब ये देखिए, लेकिन अभी भी वही फॉर्म नहीं है. एक्स मस्ट बी टेंडिंग टू 1, ए ये जो है एक्स इज टेंडिंग टू 1 होना चाहिए, ए होना चाहिए, एक्स इज टेंडिंग टू ए. तो यानी कि एक्स प्लस 1 इज टेंडिंग टू 1 होना चाहिए. तो हम लिमिट में दोनों साइड 1 कर देते हैं. ओके, लिमिट एक्स प्लस 1 इज टेंडिंग टू 1. ओके, या तो आप ऐसे लिख लीजिए या फिर आप सब्स्टिट्यूशन कीजिए. पुट x plus 1 is equal to y, y substitute कीजिए बस. जब y substitute किया limit भी change होगा. तो x is tending to y, this implies अगर आप x यहाँ पर 0 डाल दीजिए तो y is tending to क्या हो जाएगा? अगर x 0 हो जाएगा, x is tending to 0, तो y is tending to 1. तो अब आपने x will be now replaced by y, substitution हो गया हमने x plus 1 की जगह y. और जहां भी आपको x दिखाई देगा, x की जगह क्या आएगा? y. Now our variable is y. So limit y is tending to 1, x plus 1 is replaced by y. So it is y raised to power 5 minus 1 raised to power 5. X plus 1 will be replaced by y minus 1. Now it is looking same as this formula. So if we apply this formula, formula kya hai aapka? Limit x tends to a, x raised to power n minus a raised to power n upon x minus a is equal to n a raised to power n minus 1. Now check, what is a here? What is a? This is a na? You can see a is this. What is n? N is 5. So what is your formula? N a raised to power n minus 1. So aap likhi yahan par, n kya hai aapka 5, a kya hai aapke paas, that is 1. So now your answer will be n a raised to power n minus 1, n is 5, a is 1,
5 minus 1, this is 5 into 1 raised to power 4 means 1. So answer is your 5. This is also done. This is also done. You can see. Now come to this question. In this question, again, we will put the value of x. Because the limit is x is tending to 2. X is approaching to 2. So put this value here, x 2 here. So 3 into 2 square is 4 minus 2 minus 10. This is 2 square minus 4. What is this? 12. And this is minus 12. 0 upon 4 minus 4. This is 0 upon 0 form. This is indeterminate form. When you get indeterminate form, then again, as I told you, you have to think about the rationalization. Rationalization is not possible. Current root 3 kyun? Kyunki square root nahi hai. Fir factorize. Factorize kar sakte hai. Yes, we can factorize it. So, hum isko factorize karenge. हम इसको फैक्टराइज कर रहे हैं. फैक्टराइज कीजिए. देखिए ये आपका जो है लिमिट x टेंडिंग टू 2, 3x स्क्वायर माइनस x माइनस 10, x स्क्वायर माइनस 4. सो दिस इज इक्वल टू लिमिट x टेंडिंग टू 2, दिस इज 3x स्क्वायर माइनस 6x माइनस प्लस 5x माइनस 10, x स्क्वायर माइनस 2 स्क्वायर. So this is limit x tending to 2. This is 3x common x minus 2. This is 5 common x minus 2. Here this is x minus 2 and x plus 2. So this is limit x tending to 2. This is 3x plus 5 and this is x minus 2. And this is x minus 2, x plus 2. This is cancelled. Now put the value of x. 2 लिमिट की वैल्यू यहाँ पुट कीजिए. 3 इंटू 2 प्लस 5 अपॉन 2 प्लस 2, दिस इज 11 अपॉन 4. नाउ इट्स आंसर इज 11 अपॉन 4. नाउ कम टू द 8th क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर एक्सरसाइज 13.1. अगेन पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ द लिमिट. अगर आप 3 पुट करेंगे देन यू विल गेट 0 अपॉन 0 फॉर्म. यू कैन चेक इट योरसेल्फ. अगर आप इसमें 3 पुट करते हैं तो आप चेक कर लीजिए इसमें 0 अपॉन 0 फॉर्म आएगा. तो फिर आप क्या करें, इसको कैसे करना है. इसमें देखिए दिस इज x रेस टू पावर 4 माइनस 84. 81 इज 3 रेस टू पावर 4. अब करके 3 रेस टू पावर 4 इज 81. नाउ आई कैन फैक्टराइज दिस. दिस इज 2x स्क्वायर माइनस 6x प्लस x माइनस 3. सो दिस इज लिमिट x टेंडिंग टू 3. दिस इज x रेस टू पावर 4 माइनस 3 रेस टू पावर 4. And what is this? 2x common, 2x plus 1, and this is x minus 3. I don't want to factorize it there. Actually, if this can be done by two methods, I am going to apply this. Main isko follow kar rahi hu. X raised to power 4 minus 3 raised to power 4, and this is divided by 2x plus 1, x minus 3. Ek cheez na dhyan se dekho. Agar ye x is tending to 3 hai. तो x माइनस 3, अगर आप 3 को इधर ले आओ, देखो इफ x इज टेंडिंग टू 3 देन x माइनस 3 इज टेंडिंग टू 0. यही मेरा फैक्टर है जिसकी वजह से 0 आ रहा है. एंड यू कैन सी इट इज हियर. आई वुड लाइक टू कैंसिल इट. आई वुड लाइक टू कैंसिल इट. तो मैं क्या करती हूँ, x माइनस 3 से इसको डिवाइड किया. इफ आई एम डिवाइडिंग दिस एक्सप्रेशन बाय x माइनस 3, तो इसके न्यूमरेटर में ये जो है, बिकॉज दिस इज न्यूमरेटर दिस इज डिनोमिनेटर, और इसको डिवाइड करो तो इसको डिवाइड किया तो यू नीड टू डिवाइड दिस ऑल्सो एक्स माइनस 3. ठीक है, क्वेश्चन तो चेंज नहीं हुआ बिकॉज यू हैव डिवाइडेड दिस एक्सप्रेशन. ये पूरे एक्सप्रेशन को आपने एक्स माइनस 3 से डिवाइड किया, इसलिए इस पूरे एक्सप्रेशन को भी आपने एक्स माइनस 3 से डिवाइड कर दिया, जिस एक्सप्रेशन की वजह से आपका 0 आ रहा था. ठीक है, आप इसमें यू कैन सी यू कैन अप्लाई. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गोइंग टू सेपरेट दिस. आपने एलजेब्रा ऑफ लिमिट्स पढ़ा था. इन दिस आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू इन दैट वी कैन सेपरेट दिस. हाउ वी कैन सेपरेट दिस लिमिट x टेंड्स टू 3, दिस इज x रेस टू पावर 4 माइनस 3 रेस टू पावर 4 अपॉन x माइनस 3 डिवाइडेड बाय, दिस इज लिमिट x टेंडिंग टू 3, दिस इज 2x प्लस 1, x माइनस 3, x माइनस 3, दिस इज कैंसिल. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट इज लेफ्ट हियर, यू कैन सी. अब तो इजीली आपको पता चल रहा होगा विच फॉर्मूला विल बी अप्लाइड. दिस फॉर्मूला इज गोइंग टू बी अप्लाइड हियर. सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द n, n इज दिस 4. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ a, a इज दिस 3 रेज टू पावर 4 माइनस 1. डिवाइडेड बाय, पुट द लिमिट हियर, x की जगह आप 3 पुट कीजिए, 2 into 3 plus 1, so this is what 4, 3 raised to power 4 divided by, what is this, 6 plus 1, 7, okay, so now, sorry, 4 minus 1 is 3, 27 divided by 7, this is 108 by 7, okay. Hanji, question number 10, in this limit z is tending to 1, and if I put this value of limit here, z 1 minus 1 is 0, again z 1, 1 raised to power 1 by 6, 1 to the power whatever it is, the answer will be the 0, 1, so 1 raised to power 1 by 6 is 1, minus 1, 0, so 0 upon 0 form, yeah, this is the indeterminate form, so na to factorization possible hai, isme aapko bata hai, na rationalization possible hai. तो आप इन्हीं में से लिमिट्स से आप यू विल सी विच आइडेंटिटी यू विल फॉलो एंड ऑब्वियसली यू कैन सी आप देखना किससे मैच कर रहा है, इट इज मैचिंग टू दिस वन, सो वी विल टेक हेल्प ऑफ दिस वन. फॉर दिस आई एम गोइंग टू राइट इट लाइक दिस, जेड इज टेंडिंग टू वन, जेड रेज टू पावर 1 बाय 3 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाय जेड रेज टू पावर 1 बाय 6 माइनस 1. ओके, and 1 ki power to you can write anything, it will be 1, so 1 I have written as 1 raised to power 1 by 3, and here in this expression I can write this one as 1 raised to power 1 by 6, okay. So now if I want to make it, if I want to convert it into this form, what do I need? Check karo, kya cheez ki zarurat hai, isme bhi isme bhi. Z minus 1 is required there in the denominator. So I can divide this by z minus 1, question change ho gaya, so I don't want to change the question, so I will divide this by also, kyunki division mein ye cancel ho gaya, 1, theek hai na, to aapne question, aapka question bhi change, it's not changed, the question remains same if you do it on the both sides, okay. Now by applying the limit in both the cases, so what do you find, this is limit z tending to 1, z raised to power 1 by 3 minus 1 raised to power 1 by 3 upon z minus 1 divided by limit z tends to 1, z raised to power 1 by 6 minus 1 raised to power 1 by 6 divided by z minus 1. So here we will apply that formula. Here in this case what is n? This is n, what is a? A, aap dekh rahe na, z is tending to 1, limit wahi hona chahiye. Limit is also very important ki wo formula ke according hi hai ki nahi. Z must be tending to 1. You can see Z is tending to 1. So we can now apply that formula here. Ye wala formula. What is N in this case? If you match it with that, so N is 1 by 3. What is A? A is this. So N minus 1, yani 1 minus 3 minus 1 here. Divided by, what is here N? 1 by 6. What is A? 1. N minus 1, yani 1 by 6 minus 1. So 1 ki power, whatever it is, it will remain 1. So it will be 1 by 3 divided by 1 by 6. So it would become 1 by 3 multiplied by 6, that is equal to 2. Okay. So this is done. Now come to next question. In this question, if you apply the limit x is tending to 0, so a into 0 sine 0 upon b into 0. So sin 0 is 0 upon 0 form. Again this is 0 upon 0 form. And if it is 0 upon 0 form, then we need to apply and of means of factorization, that's not possible. Rationalization, that's also not possible. So then in this check, which one apply? Obviously sin will apply in this. So we will apply this. So how we would apply this? We write it like this. X tends to 0. This is sin ax divided by bx, okay. What is required here? अगर मैं इसको ये बनाना चाहती हूँ, या I would like to make it this, इस form के equal बनाना चाहती हूँ, so whatever is the angle, the same must be there in the denominator. So here, what is here as the angle? ax, the same must be in the denominator, ax होना चाहिए यहाँ पर. इधर ax चाहिए और इधर भी x हमें हटाना है. तो मुझे x चाहिए, तो मैं क्या करती हूँ, x x को लिख लिया पहले, इधर ठीक है, पहले x x लिख लिया, क्वेश्चन तो चेंज नहीं हुआ क्योंकि डिविजन का साइन है, जो इधर करेंगे वही इधर करना है, ठीक है, या फिर वही चीज इसमें मल्टीप्लाई करो। लेकिन यहाँ तो अभी ए एक्स चाहिए था, अभी तो आई हैव रिटन ओनली एक्स, सो आई विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस बाय ए एंड हियर आल्सो, क्योंकि ए से ए कैंसिल हो गया, क्वेश्चन तो चेंज नहीं हुआ ना। ओके, तो एक्स एक्स आई हैव रिटन हियर बिकॉज डिविजन इज हियर, सो क्वेश्चन इज नॉट चेंज। देखो जो भी आप यहाँ लिख रहे हैं, इधर यू राइट हियर और यू राइट हियर, ठीक। तो आई हैव रिटन हियर एक्स and here also x, I have written a here just to make it same as the angle is there in the numerator. तो a x हो गया, तो a I have written, so I have written a here also. So what it would become as per the formula, you can see this is equal to 1, this is 1 and here x is cancelled. So if this is a, if we apply the limit a into 1 divided by b, so this is a upon b, okay. So now come to, so this is also done, this is also done. Now come to the next question. This is also same as this one we have done now. This is also same. So this is sine ax divided by sine bx. अब आप देखिए इसमें अगर मैं x की जगह यहाँ पहले पुट करती हूँ 0, so sine a into 0 is sine 0, sine 0 is 0, b into 0 sine 0, that is 0. Sin 0 का क्या होता है? Value 0. So this is again 0.0 form. So I would like to convert it into this form because it is indeterminate form. तो मैं ये वाला form इसमें convert करना चाहूँगी इसमें. So here because the angle is AX, so I would like to get AX here in the denominator. And here the angle is BX, so I would like to get BX in the denominator. In AX and BX, what is common? X. चलो x तो आप लिखिए तो कैंसिल हो गया, नो प्रॉब्लम, बट हियर इट इज ए एक्स, तो a से मल्टीप्लाई और डिवाइड कर दिया, इधर भी हमने a से bx है तो b से डिवाइड और ये मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया, सो नाउ व्हाट इज दिस 1, व्हाट इज दिस 1 एज पर दिस फॉर्मूला, राइट ऑन द सपोर्टिंग रीजन, बिकॉज लिमिट x टेंड्स टू a 0 sin x अपॉन x इज 1, राइट द रीजन आल्सो, सो व्हाट इज दिस, this is 1, so a into 1 divided by b into 1, what is this, a upon b, okay, this is also a upon b. Now come to this one, 15th question. In 15th question, if you put the value of the limit pi, x ki jaga pi rakhte hain, to sin pi minus pi is sin 0, and what is sin 0 is 0, and you put x value of the limit pi, pi minus pi is 0, 0 into pi is 0, so 0 upon 0 form we are getting. So it means because this is sine, so we would like to convert into this form. So it would become 15th question, limit x tends to pi sine pi minus x, and this is pi minus x, this is very easy because as I told you, whatever is the angle, the same must be here. The same must be here, and what is as per this formula, the same must be here, and the same must be tending to 0. You can see here, x is tending to pi, x is tending to pi, so x minus pi is tending to 0. As per the formula, whatever is the angle, the same must be here, and the same angle must be tending to 0. तो वही यहाँ पर, तो यू कैन राइट, पहली बात तो ये आपका जो एक ये है पाई, हेयर ऑल्सो दिस इज पाई, तो ये तो कॉन्स्टेंट है, स्केलर है, दिस इज अ स्केलर, यू कैन टेक इट आउट लाइक दिस, यू कैन राइट एंड यू कैन रीअरेंज दिस लिमिट ऑल्सो, दिस कैन बी रिटन एक्स माइनस पाई इज टेंडिंग टू जीरो, टेक दिस पाई टू हेयर इन दिस साइड, सो एक्स माइनस पाई इज टेंडिंग टू दिस साइड, साइन पाई माइनस एक्स upon pi minus x. Now check it. What is this pi minus x? What is the angle of this sine function pi minus x? The same is here, pi minus x. And the same is here, pi minus x or x minus pi. Whatever you want to write, you can write. Pi minus x is tending to 0. So it would become 1. As per this formula, it would become 1. So this is 1 upon pi. Okay, now come to this 16th question. In 16th question, if we put 0, cos 0 is, this is cos 0, this is pi minus 0. Cos 0 is 1. So this is 1 upon pi. This is not indeterminate form. So no need to change. This is your answer. Okay? And this is question number 17. In this, if I put this 0 here, then cos 0 it would become, and you know cos 0 is 1. So this is 1 minus 1. And this is again cos 0 is 1 minus 1. So this is 0 upon 0 form. And if it is 0 upon 0 form, it means we need to do something. Factorization, no, abhi tak to. Cancellation means racialization, no. Any identity out of this, you can apply this. लेकिन इस तो भी अगर आप लगाते हैं, चलिए कोशिश करिए. अगर मैं लगाती हूँ, if I apply this formula, then I would like to do this. This is cos 2x minus 1 divided by cos x minus 1. अब क्या है? This is we know this is 0. Cos x minus 1 upon x is 0. So if I put here 0 x here x. यहाँ 2x है तो चलो 2 से multiply और divide कर दिया. But this is 0 divided by this is again 0. 0 upon 0 form आ गया. तो वी कांट अप्लाई इवन दिस आइडेंटिटी देन व्हाट टू डू भाई देखो इफ इट इज अ ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शन देन वी कैन अप्लाई एनी ऑफ द आइडेंटिटी आल्सो अब आप बोलेंगे व्हिच आइडेंटिटी वी नीड टू अप्लाई इसके लिए यू सी हियर व्हाट इज द एंगल एक्स है और ऊपर क्या है 2x है तो वी कैन अप्लाई दैट आइडेंटिटी ऑफ कॉस इन व्हिच एंगल इज क्या करते हैं हाफ हो जाएगा सो कॉस 2x की वी कैन अप्लाई दिस आइडेंटिटी यू हैव टू लर्न दिस देखो यू नीड टू लर्न ऑल द आइडेंटिटीज ऑफ द ट्रिग्नोमेट्री बिकॉज दीज आर रिक्वायर्ड हियर इन मेनी क्वेश्चंस टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द लिमिट्स सो कॉस 2x वी नो दैट दिस इज 2 कॉस स्क्वायर x माइनस 1 ये वाली आइडेंटिटी वी विल अप्लाई So here, limit x tends to 0, cos 2x minus 1 upon cos x minus 1. You can see here, angle was 2x. Now here, the angle is x. Angle is half. Half ho gaya na yahan par. To ab yahan par, agar yahan 4x hota, to yahan 2x ho jata. Yahan 6x hota, to yahan half uska 3x ho jata. Ye wali identity aisi hai. To ye aapki identity, you need to learn this. So this is cos 2x. cos 2x is equal to what is this 2 cos square x minus 1 minus this one and let it be as it is okay so now limit x tends to 0 this is 2 cos square x minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 ho jayega this is cos 2 cos square x minus 2 upon cos x minus 1 what is common 2 so limit x tends to 0 2 is common cos square x minus 1 upon cos x minus 1. Well, now what can we do? We can write this 2 means 1 square. We can make this also square. A square minus b square limit will be applied. Identity will be applied. A square minus b square means cos x minus 1 and then cos x plus 1 cos x minus 1. This will be cancelled. Now you can apply this limit x tending to 0 to. This is cos 0 plus 1. What is the value of the cos 0? That is 1 plus 1. This is 2 into 2. This is 4. So its answer will be 4. Okay. Now come to the next question. This one. So here, if you apply this limit, a into 0 is 0, x into means 0 into anything is 0, b into sine 0 is 0. So again, this is 0 upon 0 form. This is 0 upon 0 form. So what we need to do? We can write it like this. Limit x tends to 0. This is x is common from here, you can see. Or what is this? A plus cos x upon sine x. So let me tell you one thing. If it is like this, limit x tends to 0 sin x upon x, if it is equal to 1. So then I can write it like this. Limit x tends to 0, 1 upon sin x. The sin x upon x So it can be written as 1, but if it is x upon sin x. Suppose if it is, I know this is the identity. I know this is the identity, but if you find anywhere like this, limit x tends to 0, x upon sin x, then it would also be equal to 1. But how? ये कैसे 1 के इक्वल हुआ? Because I can write it like this. I can write 1 upon sin x upon x. I can write this x upon sin x as 1 upon sin x upon x. And if I apply the limit, this is I do 1. So this would be 1. So always keep it in your mind, if sin x upon x, if limit x is tending to 0 is 1, then its reciprocal would also be equal to 1. But how it is, I have made it clear to you. It would be like this. So now, in this question, you can see this is limit x tends to 0. I can rearrange it x upon sin x into a plus cos x. I have rearranged it. I have done nothing. I have just rearranged it. So now, it would become limit x tends to 0, x upon sin x into limit x tends to 0, a plus cos x. Okay? So now, I know this is 1. Now put the limit here, a plus cos 0. This is 1 into a plus, what is cos 0? That is 1. So this answer is a plus 1. I think it would be clear to everyone now. Now come to question number 19 after this. What is question number 19? This is limit x tends to 0, x secant x. It would be limit x tends to 0 and this is x is 0 and this is secant 0. Anything multiplied with 0 is 0. This is secant 0. Secant 0, we know that that is 1. That is 1. So 0 into 1 is 0. So this is also done. 17 we have done. 18 we have done. 19 we have done. Now we come to question number 20. Okay. Let me clean it. So now come to question number 20. If I put the limit, that is x is tending to 0, then sin a into 0 is sin 0 is 0, b into 0 is 0, a into 0 is 0, sin b into 0 is 0. This is 0 upon 0. So now what I am going to do? I am going to rearrange it like this, sin ax plus bx divided by ax plus sin bx, okay? I have rearranged, I know that if I divide it by x, I divide it by x, it become a little bit easier. Why I have divided? Because ax is there, so I need ax here, so at least x, so I have written now. Here sin, what is the angle of sin here? Bx. So I need bx here as the denominator. So at least I have written bx here. So if I have written x here, it is division sign, again x here. So it is cancelled, question is not changed. Okay. So now again I am going to rearrange it like this. This can be written as sin ax divided by x and plus bx divided by x. So it would become now ax divided by x. So it would be like this. Now I know this x is cancelled and I know if the angle is angle of sine function is ax and x is tending to 0, I need here ax. Ax hai to idhar ax hona chahiye. So you might be thinking ki when it is ax here, we need ax here, so there must also be ax. I know if x is tending to 0, if x is tending to 0, then if any other scalar multiplied with it, that is 0 into a, that ax is again 0. Ax is also tending to 0. That's why I am not writing it. Okay? If I am multiplying it with any scalar, so I am not going to write it here. So it would become sin A x, x b. I need here dx, so I will multiply and divide by a. Okay, so now it is a plus sin bx. I need here bx, so I will multiply and divide by b. Okay, so now what is here? This is 1 because sin ax upon ax, and ax is tending to 0 as I had explained you just now, and sin bx upon bx as x is tending to 0, so bx is also tending to 0. So this is also 1, this is also 1. So a into 1 plus b divided by a plus b into 1. So it would become a plus b divided by a plus b. So this is cancelled, so answer is 1. So its answer would be 1. Okay. Now question number 21. It is cos x minus cot x. So this is cos x, if I put the limit, this is cos x 0 minus cot 0. I know cos 0 is infinity and cot 0 is also infinity. As I told you in my last lecture, that infinity minus infinity is also indeterminate form. This is also indeterminate form. So that's why we need to do something. So we need to apply some formula of the trigonometry. I know that cos x is 1 upon sin x and cot x is cos x upon sin x. So now it will become limit x tends to 0. This is 1 minus cos x upon sin x. Okay. So now I can write it. Now I can rationalize it as you have done in your 11th class. I am going to rationalize this 1 minus cos x to 1 plus cos x, 1 plus cos x, say I can multiply. So it would become like this, 1 a minus b a plus b a square minus b square upon sin x 1 plus cos x. Now tell me, what is 1 minus cos square x? Yes, absolutely right, that is sin square x. And here it is sin x and this is 1 plus cos x. So 1 is sin x will be cancelled by sin x. Now put the value of 0. This is sin 0 upon 1 plus cos 0. We know sin 0 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. So this is 0 upon 2 and we know 0 upon any number is equal to 0. Now our last question is left, that is limit x tends to pi by 2. And this is tan 2x upon x minus pi by 2. Let us do it now. In this question, if we put the value of the limit, tan 2x ki jagah you put the value of the limit, that is pi by 2. X ki jagah pi by 2 minus pi by 2. This is tan pi and this is 0. We know tan 1 pi 0, tan 2 pi 0, tan 3 pi 0. That is 0 upon 0 form. When it is 0 upon 0 form, then we need to do something. So I am going to write it like this. X, you can see here, limit x is tending to pi by 2. And as for the formula here, whatever is the angle, the same must be here and the same must be tending to 0. And you can see here, if x minus pi by 2, agar ye idhar chala jayega, to x minus pi by 2 is tending to 0. You can see, hai na? So it means we can substitute this as y. X minus pi by 2, we can substitute as equal to y. तो हम क्या करते हैं इस क्वेश्चन में put x minus pi by 2 is equal to 1. We need to change the limit also. When x is tending to pi by 2, then y is tending to, x की जगह pi by 2 put कीजिए, pi by 2 minus pi by 2, तो y क्या हो जाएगा 0, यानी y is tending to
जीरो।
तो हमारी लिमिट चेंज हो गई, अब हम यहाँ लिख रहे हैं दोबारा क्वेश्चन को, लिमिट y रखना है, x भूल जाइए। ओके नाउ एवरीवेयर x विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय y विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस सब्स्टिट्यूशन। तो y इज टेंडिंग टू जीरो, tan 2x, x की जगह क्या आएगा यहाँ से देखिए, यहाँ से इफ x माइनस पाई बाय 2 इज y, तो x क्या होगा y एंड दिस प्लस पाई बाय 2, ये माइनस है ये इधर आ जाएगा, ये हो जाएगा x की जगह x विल बी रिप्लेस बाय y प्लस पाई बाय 2, y प्लस पाई बाय 2 ओके अपॉन x माइनस पाई बाय 2, तो x माइनस पाई बाय 2 विल बी रिटन एज y। नाउ आई विल राइट इट लाइक दिस, tan मल्टीप्लाई दिस 2y प्लस 2 will be multiplied here, so it would be right written as this, it would be limit y tending to 0 tan pi plus 2y upon y, I have rearranged it, ठीक है, I have rearranged it, tan pi plus theta होता है आपका limit y tending to 0 tan theta, theta is 2y, ये आपका formula है, that was explained trigonometry third chapter, tan pi plus theta is equal to tan theta, tan pi plus theta is equal to tan theta, so tan pi plus this is theta, तो ये क्या हो जाएगा tan theta, this is tan 2y upon y, as per this formula if angle is x the denominator must be equal to this and this limit is tending to 0. So if it is 2y here, then here also it must be 2y. So multiply and divide by 2. So what it would be, this will be now equal to 1. So this is 2 into 1, this is equal to 2 and 0. Now we'll start supplementary exercise of this chapter 13. First question is limit x tends to 0 e raised to power 4x minus 1 upon x. So if we put x 0 here, then it would become e raised to power 0 minus 1 upon 0. This is e raised to power 0 is 1 minus 1, 0. This is 0 upon 0 form. But 0 upon 0 form, then we'll see what to do. Because we can see here, directly this can be applied. क्या बिल्कुल डायरेक्टली अप्लाई हो रही है, इसमें क्या है, वट एवर इज द पावर ऑफ द ई द सेम मस्ट बी हियर, पावर ऑफ ई हियर इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू कैन सी पावर ऑफ ई इज वट इज दैट 4x, बट हियर इट इज x ओनली, सो वी कैन मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड बाय 4, सो वी कैन मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड बाय 4, तो ये हो गया आपका 4, वी कैन बिकॉज 4 इज अ स्केलर वी कैन टेक इट आउट, limit x tends to 0 e 4x minus 1 upon 4x. अब ये देखिए, if x is tending to 0 means 4x is also tending to 0, ठीक है, तो this identity can be used here, so 4 into 1 is 4, this is equal to 1 as per this identity. Now come to here, in this can be written as, if we apply it, okay, e raised to power 2 plus 0 minus e raised to power 2 upon 0. This is e raised to power 2 minus e raised to power 0. 0 upon 0 form. This is the indeterminate form. So what to do? So in this question, you can see here, we can rewrite it like this, e raised to power 2 e raised to power x. Because e raised to power 2 plus x, it can be written as e raised to power 2 e raised to power x minus e raised to power 2 upon x. So what's common here? E raised to power 2 is common here. E raised to power 2 is common. This is e raised to power x minus 1 upon x. E raised to power 2 is a constant. You can take it out. It is a scalar. You can take it out common. So it is e raised to power x minus 1 upon x. So by applying this identity, you can see here it is equal to 1. So e raised to power 2 minus 1 is equal to e raised to power 2. This is also done. So we have done this question, we have done this question. So now come to next question. If you apply the limit x is tending to 5, if you write, replace this x by 5, then it would become like this, 5 minus 5, this is 0 upon 0 form. Now 0 upon 0 form hai, indeterminate form hai, then what to do? Kya kare? Jab bhi 0 upon 0 form aata hai, it means we have to do something. Question is not completed over here. It is not finished. So what to do? I can take out, because I want to get here, as for this angle, I need to get here 1. यहाँ मुझे 1 चाहिए, 1 कैसे आएगा जब मैं e raise to power 5 कॉमन निकालूंगी, but e raise to power 5 is here but not here, so what to do? I am multiplying this with e raise to power 5 and divided by e raise to power 5, okay? Why? Because I want to take this e raise to power 5 common, इसको मुझे common निकालना है, बाहर निकालना है, इसलिए यहाँ नहीं था, इसलिए मैंने दोनों साइड ये e raise to power 5 से multiply and divide कर लिया, okay? E raise to power 5 is common now, so what's left here from here and here, this is e raise to power x divided by e raise to power 5 minus 1 upon x minus 5. Students, you can see here this can be written, because both in both of these bases are same, division over and powers will be subtracted. So this is e raised to power x upon e raised to power 5. So I can write it like this, e raised to power x minus 5 minus 1 upon x minus 5. Now as for this identity, whatever is the power of x, whatever is the power of x, same should be the same here and same should be tending to 0. तो अगर आप यहाँ पर देखिए x minus 5 here and x minus 5 here and if you take this here then it would become x minus 5 is tending to 0. So it would become like this, x minus 5 is tending to 0, e raised to power 5 because this is constant, take it out common, take it out here. So this is e raised to power 5, I have taken it here, e raised to power x minus 5 minus 1 upon x minus 5. And you can see x minus 5 is tending to 0. X minus 5, x minus 5, x minus 5. So it would become 1. So e raised to power 5 into 1, that is e raised to power 5. So this is also done. Okay. Now come to next. This is limit x is tending to 0. This is e raised to power sine 0 minus 1 upon 0. Sine 0 is 0, e raised to power 0 minus 1 upon 0, this is 1 minus 1 upon 0, this is 0 upon 0 form. 0 upon 0 form is indeterminate form, and whenever we get any indeterminate form, means the question is not getting over here. यहाँ पर खत्म नहीं हुआ आपका question, आपको कुछ और करना है, कोई identity लगानी है, factorization, cancellation, rationalization, any identity will be applied. तो standard form ही देखेंगे अब हम इसमें, ये किससे match कर रहा है, इस standard form से match कर रहा है, ये e raised to power x minus 1 upon x से match कर रहा है, तो ठीक है, इसको लिखें यहाँ पर, limit x tends to 0, e raised to power sine x minus 1 upon x, but as for this identity, whatever is the power of e, the same must be here in the denominator, so here you can see, power of e is sine x, it means sine x must be here also, but it is not here, here is it is only x, so I will multiply and divide, if it is not here I can make it, so I am trying to get this sine x here in the denominator, but how? By multiplying and dividing the expression by sine x, so I have written this sine x here and here also, I have multiplied by sine x and I have divided by sine x. Now, as you know, if x is tending to 0, obviously, if x is tending to 0, then sine x is also tending to 0. Because if you put this x is tending to 0, then sine x, sine 0 is also 0. So, it means that whatever is the power of e, that is the limit. Sine x is also tending to 0. So, now I can write it like this, limit x tends to 0, sine x upon x, okay, sine x upon x, then this is e raised to power sine x minus 1 upon this sine x. And I know that sine x upon x is also tending to 1. It's equal to 1, sorry. Sine x upon x, if limit is x is tending to 0, is equal to 1. And e raised to power x minus 1 upon x is also equal to 1 if x is tending to 0. So it means here two standard forms will be applied. This is also 1 and this is also 1. So answer is 1. Okay, 1 into 1 is 1. So this question is also done. Now come to this question. In this question, if you put here limit x is tending to 0, so this is 0, e raised to power 0 minus 1 upon 1 minus cos 0. This is 0 into anything is 0, 1 minus 1, 1 minus cos 0 is 1, 0 upon 0 form. Again, this is also 0 upon 0 form. 0 upon 0 form. So what to do? Limit x tends to 0, x e x minus 1 upon 1 minus cos x. I am going to rationalize it. 1 plus cos x upon 1 plus cos x. Because I know that if I multiply 1 minus cos x with 1 plus cos x, it would become 1 a minus b into a plus b. It would become a square minus b square, means 1 minus cos square x, and I know the value of 1 minus cos square x is sine square x. Okay, so it would become limit x is tending to 0, x e x minus 1, 1 plus cos x into 1 minus cos square x. Limit x is tending to 0, x e x minus 1, 1 plus cos x, 1 minus cos square x is sine square x. I'm going to write it separately. Now it would become x e raised to power x minus 1, 1 plus cos x divided by sine square x. You know, it is sine square x. Sine square x means sine x into sine x. You know, if you want to make it like this, sine x upon x, so I need 1x for this and 1x for this, means you need x square. It means agar aapne idhar dip kiya x x, to aapko idhar bhi likhna padega x x. 1x is cancelled by this. So now limit x tends to 0, e x minus 1 upon x, 1 plus cos x divided by sine x upon x, and this is sine x upon x. Now it would be as per this identity, it would be 1, 1 plus cos 0 divided by, this is 1, this is 1, 1 into 1, cos 0 is 1, divided by 1, 2 divided by 1 is 2. So its answer is 2. Now come to next. This is very easy. As per this identity, whatever is here, whatever is added with 1 in log function, whatever is added here, the same must be here, the same must be tending to 0. You can see here, what is added with 1, it is 2x, so 2x must be here, but here it is x. So we will multiply it with 2 and we will divide it by 2. Now it would become 1, this is 2 into 1 is 2. Now come to the last question of supplementary exercise. If you put the limit here, it is log 1. And this is sine cube 0. And we know log 1 is 0. Sine cube is also sine 0 into 0 into 0. Yani 0. 0 upon 0 form, indeterminate form. So we need to do something if it is like this. Log. We can write it 1 plus x cube divided by sine cube x, means sine x into sin x into sin x here. Sin cube x, I have written it like this. So now, as I told you, in this standard form, if whatever is added with 1, the same must be here in the denominator. 1, x cube is added with this 1, so x cube must be here. x cube, लेकिन आपने x cube से इसको divide किया, तो इसको भी x cube से करना पड़ेगा. Otherwise, the question will be changed. So x cube. So now I am going to rearrange it. This x cube can be written as x into x into x. I have rearranged it. So now it would become limit x tends to 0 log of 1 plus x cube divided by log, sorry, limit by algebra of limit x tends to 0 sine x upon x, sine x upon x, sine x upon x. So what is this? Same. And if x is tending to 0 means x cube is also tending to 0. So this is 1 as per this identity. Divided by sin x upon x 1, sin x upon x is 1, sin x upon x is 1 if limit x is tending to 0. So this is 1 into 1 into 1. So 1 divided by 1 is 1. So this was the last question of supplementary exercise. Now in my next lecture I will tell you how we will find out the limit in those questions in which the function changes function changes at a particular point. Then how we'll find out the limit in those cases.